We honor her. We have a great devotion to her. But we also know that a lot of our friends who are not Catholic Christians struggle with that. And if they're polite to us, many of them say, I just think you give a little too much emphasis. You put a little too much emphasis on her. Why not all on Jesus? And if they're not so polite, they'll say, you worship Mary, when you should only worship God and God alone. And so why do you do that? You're not really Christian. Someone will even tell us. So it's important for us to know why we have this great devotion to Mary, and why that's important to us, and why a day like this brings us such great joy. So when people ask me about that, when they say, why do you Catholics put so much emphasis on Mary? I mean, why even focus on her? Why not just give all of your attention to Jesus? And I always ask them, because usually it's coming from a more of a fundamentalist biblical point of view, I say, well, you know Luke chapter 1, right? You know Luke 1, don't you? And, you know, put it back on them. And there it says that the angel Gabriel was sent by God to Mary. And the angel said to Mary, hail, highly favored daughter. She is God's highly favored one, God's favored daughter. So that right there is a reason to honor Mary. If she is God's favored daughter, if God sent an angel to greet her, that's good enough for me. And so I want to honor her just as God did as well. And then what does Mary say when she's filled with the Holy Spirit, when she's with her cousin Elizabeth? She says, my soul glorifies and magnifies the Lord. My whole being exalts God, my Savior. And then later on, she says, all generations will call me blessed. Why? Because she's done great things? No. Because she said, because God, who is mighty, has done great things in me. So we do what it says in the Bible. We call her the Blessed Virgin Mary. And everything we give to Mary, any prayer, any devotion, is really directed to God. For Mary says, everything, my soul, my whole being, magnifies the Lord. Now that makes me think of a magnifying glass. I know it's kind of an interesting image for Mary. I kind of picture Mary there with like a big magnifying glass with legs. No, it's not that. And unfortunately, as a boy, I might have, you know, magnified and killed a lot of ants with a magnifying glass. So get that out of your mind. And now that I'm older, I actually use it to read, so I appreciate that. But a magnifying glass takes the light, right, and it focuses it into a very sharp point onto one object. It could burn that thing if it's the sun, or it could really expose that thing, you know, if it's something really small. And Mary says, my whole being magnifies the Lord. So I just have this image of all of our prayers, all of our devotion to Mary goes right through her and is magnified. It just reaches God in a very wonderful way, a very concentrated way. So if someone says we worship Mary, I say, you can't. Everything you give to Mary goes right through her, if you will. It's magnified and it goes to God, who alone deserves our worship and praise, God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So that's why devotion to Mary is so important for us. We're following what it says in the Bible. We are doing what God does. We honor her, and in so doing that, all of our prayers and devotion go back to God. Now, why is this feast today, the Feast of the Assumption, so important? Well, it's important because of this. As God called her his highly favored daughter, Mary had this special union with her son, of course, that none of us could ever have, because she gave birth to the Son of God. So all his life, Mary had this singular devotion to him, to her son, in such a unique and wonderful way. She even shared with him, we say, his passion. And his death, she was there as he was taken down from the cross and laid in the tomb. She suffered with him as well. She rejoiced with the other disciples in the upper room when she heard the great news of the resurrection and was among them to preach the good news for the first time. Mary shared the life of her son in a singular way, so important, that it makes complete sense that she would share everything. Even at the end of her life, and this is interesting, you can believe that she died or that she just fell asleep. We're not really sure. But the teaching says that at the end of her life, she was taken up body and soul into heaven. In a wonderful way, she shared in the resurrection with her son. And that is such an awesome thing for a couple of reasons. One, it's just kind of, it's an awesome thing to imagine that Mary just kind of, okay, I'm done, kind of laid down, and then was taken up into heaven. But it's really wonderful because of this. today in this Mass, that where Mary has gone, we hope to follow. What we're seeing in celebrating Mary's Assumption into heaven is what will happen to all of us, please God, at the end of our life in the resurrection on the last day, that we too will be raised body and soul into heaven. And this is why we rejoice, because one of us, one of our very own, a human being, Mary, made it. She is in heaven as well with all the saints. And we know that for sure, and where she has gone, we hope to follow. That's why this is such an important feast day for us. That's why devotion to Mary is so important. We do what God does. We honor Mary as the Mother of God, the Mother of the Son of God. And we hope to follow her with a single-hearted devotion to her Son, so that after having walked well with him and her on earth, that we too may be lifted body and soul into the kingdom of God. Let that be our prayer, let that be our devotion, let that be our focus. Everything we're all about is trying to be more and more like Mary, whose whole being magnified the Lord her God, who had this special devotion, this single-hearted devotion to her Son, and now is with him forever and ever. May the same thing happen to us.